Greetings, everybody. This is Questeon, and I maintain a forum and a blog that focuses on Stefan Molyneux and the Free Domain Radio community. Now, why in the world would I do that? Well, Stefan Molyneux can be thought of in three different ways. Number one is a teacher and explainer of other people's ideas. Number two is a philosopher and originator of his own ideas. And number three is an expert on family relationships and parenting. I also think that Molyneux's success in each of these three areas varies widely. When it comes to being a teacher and explainer of other people's ideas, I think he does a wonderful job. He's very articulate, he's brilliant, he's funny, and he has a wonderful way of taking difficult-to-understand concepts and putting them in a way that are easily graspable. As far as being an originator of ideas, of being a philosopher, I'm going to leave that in the hands of other critics for now. Generally, people who are emotionally invested in the Free Domain Radio community tend to give his works high reviews. But for critics who otherwise have no involvement with Free Domain Radio, the reviews are, I'll just say, mixed. For now, I'll leave it at that. It's the third area, Molyneux's role as an authority on parenting and family relationships, where I take the greatest exception. In analyzing these actions and activities, and their impact on the Free Domain Radio community, has been the subject of my blog, FDR Liberated, since its inception. In the last year, something exciting has happened. We've now added a forum to the site. It now has dozens of members, most of whom are former Free Domain Radio members, some of whom are philosopher kings. Many of them left FDR of their own volition, and they have some fascinating insights on Molyneux's psychology teachings and their impact. When you read their accounts on how FDR negatively impacted their lives and relationships, it can be very moving. Now, some of what they have to say may be surprising to many, maybe even most of the people who listen to Stefan Molyneux, because, once again, you can think of his followers in three different groups. The outer group, as I like to think of it, are people who enjoy Molyneux as a YouTube personality, where most of his videos are focused on interviews, current events, or libertarian or freedom-related topics. They may find his videos on psychology or relationships interesting conceptually, although they do not apply them to their lives in the way Molyneux actually recommends, as you'll see. The next group are people who not only consume the YouTube videos, but also visit his forum. They look at it as one of the many libertarian or freedom-related forums they visit. They pretty much focus on that aspect, and again, tend to pay less attention to the family issues. I would suspect that most of Stefan Molyneux's fans fall into those two categories. They might be surprised to learn that they are, by Molyneux standards, hypocrites. You see, Molyneux tends to be an absolutist in his philosophy and psychology views, and he intends for them to be followed whole. And it is that third inner group who have committed. They are fully invested in Molyneux's views on family and psychology, and many of them have abandoned their former relationships as a result. It's this group that FDR Liberated focuses on. So that's basically what FDR Liberated is all about. If I do videos in the future, I'll get into the above points in greater detail. But in the meantime, please feel free to visit the forum. If you have any interest in Stefan Molyneux, you'll find it very interesting reading, and you are cordially invited to join in. If I were to do one video about Molyneux, it would have to be about the next subject, the curious practice advocated by FDR known as defooing. For those new to the subject, defooing is a term created by Molyneux. I don't know of a legitimate psychologist who uses it, and in fact, legitimate psychologists condemn it as it is practiced at FDR. The term is based on the acronym FOO, which means family of origin. Technically, to defoo means to discard one's family of origin. Molyneux was promoted defooing as long as Free Domain Radio has existed, although few outsiders, even those in the outer two circles I mentioned, fully understand what he means. The conventional interpretation is that Molyneux believes you have no moral obligation to continue relations with a parent or parents who abuse you. I agree with that, and I would challenge any church or state-based ethical stance that claims otherwise. However, that doesn't actually describe defooing as it is actually practiced at FDR. The documentation on my blog and the accounts given by the members of the FDR Liberated Forum show otherwise. I guess this is my video of threes. because now I'm going to outline three important elements of FDR defoeing that you may be unaware of. You may find them challenging, but they are heavily documented on my site. They are the main reasons you should question the practice and the man who promotes it. Reason 1. Defoo means everybody. I believe that pop psychologist John Bradshaw popularized the idea of separating from the toxic people in your life, even if it's your entire family. His notion is that you can create a family of choice to give you the kind of support that your family of origin cannot. He does not advocate automatically abandoning everyone in your life. But that is what Stefan Molyneux did when he borrowed Bradshaw's idea and renamed it defooing. Molyneux cut ties with his entire family and his friends. His wife Christina, who previously believed that she had a happy childhood, changed her view when she met Molyneux and ultimately rejected her entire family and even the Greek community in which she was raised.
She believed that the Greek community was good and that her parents were nice and that, you know, they were really into family and education and they were very tight and it was a good thing.
One of the things that you had almost created was throughout your 20s, you talked about how great your family was.
I really firmly believed it at the time.
So, what traumatic event caused Christina to change her mind about her family?
When my wife's relationship with her parents began to unravel, it was when I came over.
As Molyneux recounts in this podcast, he continually questioned his new girlfriend and made observations about her family until her childhood memory slowly changed from one of a happy household with nice parents to one where she lived a life of forced compliance under fear of abandonment, which he also details in podcast 1125, Attacking Parents. In podcast FDR 1019, which was previously premium podcast number 79, entitled We Are Full of Treasure, Molyneux asked several of his closest followers how many times they meet people outside of FDR worth talking to. Like a good attorney, he asks the question because he already knows what they're going to say. One by one, each of them declare that they never meet anyone outside of FDR worth talking to. However you have heard defoo defined in the past, the empirical evidence demonstrates that Molyneux's followers abandon everyone. The majority of defooers, including Molyneux and his wife, leave all family, extended family members, and most or all of their friends. In a number of personal counseling sessions with his followers, Molyneux proves to the follower that the parent he or she feels close to is actually worse than the parent he or she disdains. Therefore, both must be abandoned. Soon, siblings who refuse to get on board are deemed corrupt, followed by friends, etc. And for those who are concerned that FDR may be a destructive cult, at least as far as those closest followers are concerned, it sends up a red flag because a defining characteristic of all destructive cults is isolating the new member from outside influences. I'm not saying that that's what's happening here. I'm simply making the case that the term defoo is probably inept, since it is not limited to family. Molyneux's closest followers typically abandon everyone. So how is that possible if defooing is a response to abuse, as is commonly claimed? That brings us to point number 2. Defoo isn't about abuse. It's about thought crimes. A significant amount of materials at FDR, including the But My Parents Were Really Nice podcast, and books such as On Truth and Real-Time Relationships, are devoted to convincing you that your parents are corrupt, to use Molyneux's term. It's important to pay attention to that term. Someone who is corrupt is simply someone who doesn't share Molyneux's worldview. It's your first hint that defooing really doesn't have anything to do with actual abuse. The intellectual foundation of FDR can be found in a short essay Molyneux wrote in 2005 entitled, Are People Just Stupid? In the essay, Molyneux describes nearly all parents this way. So face it, your parents were bullies, or weak couriers of favor, or manipulative emotional infants themselves. You have no respect for them, for respect requires courage, and courage requires logical morality. You do not love them, since love demands virtue, and manipulating children into blind obedience is not at all virtuous. His relationship advice is as follows. You were told to repair things with your parents, but that is an impossible task, a complete waste of time that will also make you crazy. The solution? As my wife says, it all starts with the family. If you want to perform the greatest service for political liberty, all you have to do is turf all of your unsatisfying relationships. Parents, siblings, spouse. It doesn't matter. That solution may sound reasonable, except Molyneux believes that all of your current relationships are unsatisfying, just as he believes nearly all parents are horribly bad. Anyone who goes to Molyneux for family advice is dealing with a man who believes that all children are prisoners.
Our childhoods, our collective childhoods, were prisons. And I know I'm going to get even more emails about this. And people, oh, I had a good relationship with my mom and dad. Oh, they were fine. They were this, they were that. No, I'm sorry. I got to tell you, and I hate to say it because I don't mean to be a bully, but you're wrong.
Defooing has nothing to do with actual abuse, no matter how many times you hear otherwise. In the FDR world, it appears to be a necessary step one must take to become a healthy, virtuous libertarian. Molyneux once banned a forum member simply for insisting that he had a loving relationship with his Christian parents. As I said before, if you don't subscribe to Molyneux's worldview, you are corrupt. Because defooing is based on thought crimes rather than actual abuse, it becomes easier to lump the defooees together because you are leaving them for their corrupt thinking rather than their actions. Number 3. Defooing is an act targeted to a specific age group. This is slippery but very important. FDR was created to catch young people at the point of individuation, or, as Molyneux says it, he needed to reach the kiddies.
But it was through the suggestions of my wife that I really began to feel that I had something new and unique to offer. And believe it or not, this is all related to this initial question of children and parental obligations and fundamentally the great challenge of how to reach the kiddies, how to reach the children, and the challenges of all of this.
Current FDR members remain unembarrassed that Molyneux thinks of them as the kiddies. John Bradshaw's works are focused at older adults, primarily those suffering from addictions or similar problems, problems that may be related to the roles they played in their family of origin. But Molyneux was specifically targeted a group of people in their late teens and early 20s, the age group that universally struggles in their quest to become independent adults, and intentionally glorifies defooing, an act you will not find duplicated anywhere except, once again unfortunately, in destructive cults. A recent development in the Free Domain Radio community highlights the problem with Molyneux's advocacy of defooing. Longtime FDR members know that Molyneux and his wife Christina, a practicing therapist who runs her own family clinic, started FDR together, and for several years Christina participated in a number of defooing-related podcasts and even had her own Ask a Therapist series at FDR. However, when the Ontario College of Psychologists, who oversee licensing for Ontario, began to look into Christina's involvement, all of those podcasts were scrubbed from the FDR site. Ultimately, the college found Christina guilty of professional misconduct and suspended her license for her participation in FDR. At the hearing, the prosecutor noted, "Your statements in support of defooing are not supported by current professional literature or consistent with the standards of the college." However, they did not terminate her license because a random sampling of her patient files revealed that she never advocates the practice with her own patients at her own clinic. What does that tell you? This brief introduction can't cover all aspects of this bizarre FDR practice. However, you'll find much more information on my blog, where you'll find all of the statements I've made here backed up in Molyneux's own words. Even more interesting are the accounts given by ex-FDR members on our forum. I really hope you found this video interesting and maybe even thought-provoking. If you do, maybe you can drop by the FDR Liberated Forum and share your thoughts. We'd love to hear from you.